Okay, so I just wanted to ask Dennis some questions, so can I get 10 minutes? Okay. A lot of questions on your presentation. One is, you said you tried 20 different religions or whatever, and one of them was secular humanism. So I would like to say, what is the problem with secular humanism? Because as far as I can tell, it's much superior.
Ta-da! It's the world and the errors that they're making, and people are getting hurt. And
so, what's an error specifically?
With secular humanism?
Yeah. What's wrong about it? You said it doesn't work. So what's
you just look at social statistics. The social statistics have gradually gone down over the decades, and you know, people are unhappy. People commit suicide. People turn to addictions because they're not happy.
But what's that have to do with secular humanism?
Well, secular humanism is a religion. And it's got, every religion has two parts to it. One part is you define existence, and that's evolution. And the other part is you define morality, and it's the morality that's not working.
What's so bad about the morality of secular humanism?
Divorce.
No, secular humanists don't say that you should get a divorce.
No, but they allow it in their religion.
Doesn't the Christian religion allow divorce?
Not really, no.
I mean, which Christian religion does not allow divorce?
The Bible. I just go by the Bible. With me, it's, you know, the Bible is from God, it's from perfection. And there is a, you know, like a loophole there for divorce. But
okay, so you have your own interpretation of the Bible. You don't, I mean, there's no denomination. There's no mainstream denomination. I mean, there's always cults that have all kinds of beliefs, but there's no mainstream denomination that would agree with you that divorce, you know, is not allowed.
Well, that's not true, exactly. The only way they get around it, there's compromise.
I mean, we'll name one large Christian denomination that says divorce is not allowed.
Catholic?
They do...
You have to go through a whole bunch of stuff.
Right?
Yeah, annulment, but that's, like I said, the compromise. They say that it never was a real marriage in the first place. People were either coerced or... And you have to go before a tribunal. Muslims are doing the same thing. That's part of Sharia law.
Well, also, I think if you do get divorced as a Catholic, they don't excommunicate you, I don't think.
Yeah, they do. If you... you can't make a communion if you get a divorce without going through the tribunal thing.
Yeah.
Annulment.
Well, you're not even supposed to go to communion if you miss a Sunday Mass either, because...
No, I don't know about that. That's another thing that you brought up, by the way, that, you know, as far as the Eucharist and all that, you know, the actual body and blood of Jesus.
Right.
Nobody says that. I mean, Jesus said, do this in remembrance.
I know, but I was raised a Catholic, and I talked to my dad. I mean, I studied Catholicism a lot. They say it is literally the body and blood of Jesus. That's why it's a scandal if they spill they have to eat all the host. They have to eat.
That's the world. I you know, what I do in my work is I try to make people go directly to God, as Jesus said, in spirit and in truth.
Well, okay.
Spirit's in here, truth is in the Bible.
Okay, so I wanted to find out specifically, what does secular humanism teach as a precept that you say is not good or bad? They don't say, of course they say accept divorce if people get divorced, but they don't say you should get divorced.
Okay, that's one thing. That's just one thing. You know, you have to look at the disconnect between secular humanist, and I'm talking about political correctness now, secular humanist precepts and what the Bible says, and nature. See, you can just, so say for instance, homosexuality. If people do that, what are some of the consequences? AIDS, STDs, broken hearts, you know. There's a lot of things in nature. I mean, you're actually fighting nature, so.
Well, I mean, heterosexuals also have the STDs and everything too.
Well, only if they're promiscuous, but there's no, in a heterosexual marriage, that is a commitment for life between a man and a woman, there's no STDs.
Okay, well, let me ask you about this one thing, too. On your timeline, you said, you know, we come into existence.